Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Avery, and these are all of the ebooks that I ended up downloading in February. I ended up downloading 29 ebooks in the month of February, all for free. So let's get started and I'll show you what I downloaded. The first book that I ended up downloading is Surrender to the Cyborgs by Grace Goodwin. This is still available to download for free. Wrongly imprisoned whistleblower Rachel Pierce would rather take her chances with her court appeal than accept her place as the first interstellar bride destined for the colony. She's stubborn and determined to seek justice and her freedom on Earth, but her mates are not willing to risk her life or her future on a system they believe to be both primitive and corrupt. Maxim of Prixlon Prime fought 10 long years in the Hive Wars, captured and tortured with his second Ryston. They escaped only to be rejected by their own people and condemned to life on the colony with the other contaminated cyborg warriors. As leader of Sector 3, it's Maxim's duty to set an example for his warriors and summon a bride. When she refuses transport, he can't allow her rejection to demoralize an entire planet of battle-hardened but jaded warriors. Maxim and Ryston transport to Earth, where they decide she is theirs and a maximum security human prison will not keep them apart. Getting Rachel to the colony is the first challenge they will face. Convincing their beautiful mate to surrender to not one but two dominant warriors is another. Even if they can win her love, a new evil is rising in the colony and someone close to Maxim will be its first victim. Maxim will be its second, unless Rachel's love and relentless pursuit of the truth proved strong enough to save him. Then I have Music Man by K.L. Montgomery, and it is still currently free to download. Love and fame can come at any age, but be careful for what you wish for. Even at 40, plus-size writer Claire is infatuated with her own personal rock star. Is it the beard? The flannel, the guitar? Claire isn't sure, but Jack is simply irresistible. It's no wonder she pushes him to audition for a local singing contest. You're never too old to chase your dreams, right? Music was Jack's first love. When life got in the way of him making it big as a singer/songwriter, he settled for teaching music, including giving piano lessons to the stunning, curvy redheaded named Claire. He's fallen head over heels for her, just in time for his big break to finally arrive. But do you ever really give up on your first love? Okay, sorry y'all, the angle was bothering me, so I switched it around. Next I have To Pillage a Pirate by Heather C. Myers. This is still available to download for free. Belle has no intention of returning to Port Royal to a life she wants to forget. She needs to get off Tortuga and to start a new chapter in her life, not take a step back. Everyone, including her family, thinks she's dead, and she plans to keep it that way. Captain Donovan offers her way off Tortuga in exchange for her services, posing as his bride to gain trust from a wealthy tradesman. But Belle soon realizes the pirate's plan to pillage and plunder the tradesman estate will only draw attention to Belle's attempt to escape. After all, the wealthy tradesman is Belle's father. If Belle's life isn't the only one hanging in the balance, Donovan is wanted for his multiple crimes against the crown. If he's discovered, he'll be hanged in the gallows, and Belle's haunting secret past may make her more of a risk than an asset. Belle and Donovan have nowhere else to turn but to each other, but accepting one another's help could ruin everything. Then I have The Negotiator by Avery Flynn. This is available to purchase for $3.99. Wanted, personal buffer. Often snarly, workaholic executive seeks buffer from annoying outside distractions, aka people. Free spirits with personal boundary issues, excessive quirks, or general squeamishness need not apply. Salary negotiable. Confidentiality required. Workaholic billionaire Sawyer Carlyle may have joked he needed a buffer from their marriage-obsessed mom, but he didn't need a waiting room filled with candidates to further distract him. Thanks, bro. But when a sexy job applicant shoos his mom and the socialite in tow out of his office, Sawyer sees the genius of the plan and the woman. In fact, Miss Clover Lee might just be the fastest promotion in history. From buffer to fake fiancé. This free spirit might look like hot sunshine and lickable rainbows, but she negotiates like a pit bull. Before Sawyer knows what hit him, he's agreed to give up Friday nights for reality TV, his Saturdays for flea markets, his Tuesdays and Thursdays for date nights, aka panty-losing opportunities if he plays his cards right. And now she wants lavender bath salts and tulips delivered every Monday? Yep, she's just screwing with him. Good thing she's got this non-negotiable 6 weeks and she's gone rule, or Sawyer may have just met his match. Then we have Bound to the Elven Prince by Lisa Kumar. this is still available to download for free. College student Cal Warner spends a good portion of her time trying to keep people from thinking she's crazy, but her carefully constructed reality is turned upside down when she discovers that Raelyn, the seductive elven prince who has been starring in her sensuous fantasies, isn't merely a myth. Now she's bound to an elf and stuck in a magical land where no one, least of all Raelyn, is willing to spill any answers about the truth of her arrival. Raelyn has lived a life that hasn't changed in millennia, and he likes it that way. As prince of the Aryan people, he has conscripted duties, and a human woman, even one as desirable as Cal, does not fit into them. But as the enemy dark kindred knock on the borders and the magic of his people fades, he might just have to find room. The only other hurdle, he has to make her fall in love with him so she'll tie her life to his forever. Then we have Soulless by Kate Rudolph. This is still available to download for free. There is nothing left in Raze. No love, no hate, nothing except the duty that he owes his people. But when he meets a fascinating and tough human woman on a barren planet, something deep inside him comes back to life, and for the first time in years, he yearns for more. When a mission for the Soul Intelligence Agency gets out of hand, Sierra will need to use every skill she has and work with a mysterious alien warrior who awakens an unquenchable desire within her. He's cold and forbidding, but he looks at her like there's a fire in his eyes that opens up a whole world of possibilities. The chemistry between Raze and Sierra is too hot to ignore, even if it should be impossible for a mate bond to form between them. But if Raze's emotions fully return before he claims his Denya, he might end up dead for good. There is no fighting destiny, especially for a doomed Dayton, and Raze already cheated fate once. To be with Sierra, he'll have to do it all over again, or neither of them will make it out alive. Then we have A Vicious Prince by Lily Saint Germain, and this is still available to download for free. An arranged marriage, a brutal abduction, and a love so forbidden it might destroy them both. Avery Capulet is missing, taken by a madman, kept in the dark. She might not survive. He'll use her body, destroy her mind, all before he ever lays a hand on her. Rome Montague is a drug dealer, a criminal, a thief. And he needs the secrets Avery and her family are keeping, even if it means cutting them out of her pretty Capulet flesh. Rome Montague is missing, but nobody will miss him. Not that it matters. After the things he's done to this girl, he doesn't deserve to be found. Then we have Captive Mates by M.J. Guida. I'm so sorry if I'm mispronouncing that. This is available off of Kindle Unlimited, or you can purchase it for $2.99. He's a dragon alien warrior who believes in fated mates, but she'll never be anyone's mate ever again. Rory has powers that no other dragon from the planet of Zalara possesses, but he can't control them until he meets her. Arya learned the hard way to trust no one, especially her suitors. After her sweetheart's betrayal leads to the murder of her rebel brothers, her soul burns for retribution. When she's awakened from a magic sleep by a dragon warrior from another world claiming her as his own, she refuses to give him her heart. A space horde hell-bent on intergalactic conquest will force these two to fight together and maybe even fall in love. Then I downloaded Indulging Her by Leah Ellen. This is still available to download for free. I am going to be ruined, bankrupt, my childhood dream of running my own bakery shattered. What was I thinking trying to run a business all by myself? I don't know anything about marketing, financial planning, sales, or budgeting, but I can't imagine doing anything else. What am I going to do? I've already put everything I had into this bakery, all my savings, my heart, blood, sweat, and tears. Now I'm doomed. And all this was before the big chain bakery opened its doors across the street from mine. That's when I met Jackie Powell while working on an upmarket catering job on the side. Her gorgeous red hair, long-toned legs, and stunning curves caught my attention. Her confidence, demeanor, and mouth-watering scent make me forget about all my troubles, if only for a moment. Gone were the thoughts of home and pajamas. Now all I can focus on is her plump, glossy, kissable lips. Was this for real? Could something good come out of this terrible situation? Was I going to meet the woman of my dreams tonight? Then I downloaded This Changes Everything by Jennifer Ashley. This is still available to download for free. Meet the McLaughlins, four gorgeous brothers and a close-knit family and ladies who love them. This changes everything. Zach McLaughlin was Abby's first crush, hot, enticing, out of reach. Then comes the wedding, where Zach is the best man to the groom, his brother, and Abby's maid of honor. A few bottles and some dancing later, Abby finds herself waking up next to Zach after a mind-blowing one-night stand. Zach can't believe Abby has become such a beautiful woman. Their first kiss long ago had been a mess, but being with Abby now stirs fire in his soul. But Abby vanishes in the morning, and Zach is left with beautiful memories and a determination not to let her go so easily, even if he has to recruit his infuriating brothers to help him. Zach is going to find a way to change everything. Then I downloaded Don't Go Stealing My Heart by Kelly Siskind. This is available to purchase for $3.99. Some people would call Clementine Abernathy a criminal. She considers herself a modern day Robin Hood who steals from the rich and gives to the poor. Not exactly on the up and up, but she knows what it's like to lose everything. Her latest heist involves swiping a priceless Van Gogh from its owner, who's supposed to be an egotistical trust fund brat. Turns out Jack David is a sexy, kind-hearted man, and Clementine is in trouble. Falling for her mark would make her the world's dumbest con woman, but Jack is charmingly persistent, always singing sweet songs in her ear, and the earth-shattering kiss, she never stood a chance. Now she's imagining a fresh start with this dashing man, but that means telling Jack about her past, and other nefarious sorts are after the painting too. Too soon, Clementine learns what it means to risk it all for love. Then I downloaded Sweet Mercy by K.A. Tucker. This is available to purchase for $4.99, or you could get it off of Kindle Unlimited. One night, my father in prison convicted for a murder he did not commit, and I've attracted the attention of the last man I'd ever want knowing that I existed. Gabriel Easton, son of an infamous crime boss, deplorable womanizer, scoundrel to the core. Worse, he has figured out how desperate I am to protect my father from brutality behind bars. He has the power to grant that protection, and he has offered it for a price. I am to become a guest in his mansion to live with him until he tires of having me around. I'll do anything for my father, including agree to Gabriel's cruel game, but I won't comply with his every woman wish. Not that he taunts me with the ruthless spark in his cold blue eyes, not when he requires that I share his bedroom at night. Unfortunately for me, I think my loathing for him is what he enjoys the most. That's fine. By the time I'm through with him, he'll be crying my name. Mercy. Then I downloaded The Alien King's Prey by Loki Reynard. This is available to purchase for $3.99, or you could get it off of Kindle Unlimited. King Archon is a dominant, ruthless hunter interested in only war and conquest, much to the sorrow of his advisors who insist he should select a mate and produce an heir. To escape the expectations of court, Archon travels to break a human rebellion. When one of the human females defies him and escapes his wrath, she marks herself as his prey. He vows to hunt her to the very end of the world and exact punishing justice on her tender flesh. A young human woman has almost no chance against an all-powerful alien king, but Iris is not as weak as she seems. This will be Archon's most dangerous hunt yet. Then I downloaded Eric, a time travel romance by Joanna Bell. This is available off of Kindle Unlimited, or you could purchase it for 99 cents. As a child, Paige Renner is no stranger to loneliness and sorrow. When her mother dies, she's left with her grief-stricken father, a man reduced to a shadow of his former self. But Paige discovers the perfect escape, a hidden and secret place lost in time, the medieval village of Castelli. Only Paige can enter the tiny hamlet. There, among the children of the villagers, she finds friendship and affection. As the years pass, she grows into a young woman and her visits grow fewer. Home from college, Paige decides to return one last time, but instead of finding a peaceful village, she arrives to find it in flames. Vikings are attacking Castelli. The English town offers Eric and his men little in the way of booty. A few pigs, a few sacks of grain, some gold and silver. Most of the inhabitants have already fled, but few remain. One in particular, a woman, catches the warrior's eye. She's oddly dressed, but commonly, and she seems innocent, as if she's never known the touch of a man. After a little teaching, the chestnut-haired wench should warm his bed nicely, but the woman is as frightened as a spring lamb. Her panic and terror of Eric make betting her a test of his patience. To coax her into his arms, he'll have to be gentle with her, take his time, and show her a more tender side of himself. As the days pass and his heart softens, Eric vows to win Paige's love. A harsh winter keeps Paige trapped with her Viking captor. The nights are long and cold, and the snow deepens. A fragile truce forms between them. With every tender touch, he claims a little more of her heart, but the memories of her old life linger. She worries about her father and her duty to return to modern time for his sake. When Eric is wounded, Paige realizes that without modern medicine, her Viking lover will likely die. Does she dare return to the future and risk never making it back to him? Or does she remain by the side of the man she has come to love as he fades away before her eyes? Then I ended up downloading Falling at First Sight by Willow Winters. This is still available to download for free. His smile is what got me. It was charming, but held a hint of the sexy thoughts I was hoping he had in his head, like I did with Only Our First Glance. He may be tall, dark, and handsome, but I'm telling you, it was his smile that got me. I'm sure of that detail. Too bad all I did was avert my gaze and let a blush rise to my cheeks, outing me for having sordid thoughts about my son's preschool teacher. Trent Morgan was everything I ever wanted, but there was no way I was going there, even if I had fallen at first sight. Then I ended up downloading Opposites Attract by Camilla Isley. I'm sorry if I'm butchering that. This is still available to download for free. First law of magnetism: opposite poles attract. Single mom Vivian has been burned by love once before, and her job as a divorce lawyer has presented enough evidence to convince her that there are no good men left in New York City. The worst offender is her new neighbor, Dr. Lucas Keller, a couples therapist whose piercing blue eyes and flawless dark hair are just as annoying as his bad temper. When Lucas starts poaching Vivian's clients by saving their marriages, she makes it her mission to force him out of the building to save her practice. But it's Lucas who gives her the perfect opportunity when he proposes the unexpected bet. With their offices at stake, Vivian and Lucas play the field of love in a fierce battle of wits that quickly turn hot and personal, especially when Vivian's daughter gets involved. Now, taking down Lucas has become more than business for Vivian. It becomes a pleasure. And soon, Lucas and Vivian will realize how pointless it is to fight the laws of attraction. This is a fun neighbors to lovers romance comedy filled with heart. Then I downloaded Off of Kindle Unlimited, Bound by the Ice Alien by Alex X, I'm pretty sure that's how you pronounce that. Aizon purchased a human woman from the dying earth to serve as a nanny to his children. Her curves and sass are putting this alien lord to the test. Screw this dying planet and screw Terra Link with its relocation program that's some kind of glorified off-world skin trade. Everyone only signs up because it's the only way to escape Earth before the whole thing gets burned to a crisp. And yes, I signed up too. If I'm going to get off this rock, it's my only option. I don't even care if I have to set up as a breeder or a slave. Like hell, I'm going to die on Earth. So it would be just my luck that I'd find myself in the hands of a powerful alien captain and sent to a planet of ice dragon shifters with tempers and wandering hands. He keeps showing up, complaining that I'm spunky, feisty, and way too curvy for his tastes, which I would believe if he didn't keep pulling me against him. If I had to guess, the whole thing is going to end in a tangle. Sheets included. Then I downloaded Scarlett's Naughty Christmas, a bubble bath short romance by Max Watson. There you go, sorry. This is still available to download for free. It's Christmas, which means screaming kids, carols on repeat, and angry, impatient parents giving me the evil eye. Every year, I think this part-time gig as Santa's helper will fill me with Christmas cheer, and every year I'm left at Santa's altar while he's kicking off drinking himself into a stupor. It's time I gave up and quit this nonsense already. But then the latest Santa rent a drunk, Luke, turns out not to be drunk at all. In fact, he is a hunky hottie that has me drooling and falling all over myself. I may not get filled with Christmas cheer this year, but maybe I can get this sexy Santa to stuff my stocking. Then I downloaded Charlie's Sexy Valentine, and this is the second book to the book I just read before this one. This is still available to download for free. I hate my neighbors. They're loud, obnoxious, and heavy-footed. I can't remember the last time I slept. When their little dance parties lead to work mishaps that have me on leave, that's the final straw. But when I bang on their door to complain, Charlie, a curvaceous and captivating woman, answers the door and my brain shuts down. Before I know it, she and her roommate are dragging me around their Valentine's Day bash that somehow ends up with her locked out and stuck in my apartment. If I ravage this wild woman the way I desperately want to, can things go back to normal? Do I even want them to? It's Valentine's Day and my first holiday in the big city of Dallas, Texas. My roommate loves loud music, which I don't mind until my neighbor starts complaining. Lars shows up on my doorstep angry and uptight, but something about this sexy, straight-laced stranger has me wanting to tempt him to let loose on this lover's day. Does my sexy Valentine have a wild side? Then I downloaded One Night with the Rebel by Kendall Ryan. This is still available to download for free. She barged into my life and turned everything upside down. We spent one scorching hot night night together, and then she disappeared into the sunset with the golden jock everyone adored. Which makes sense, right? A girl as beautiful and brilliant as Eden Wynn doesn't end up with a rebel like me. I expected them to live happily ever after, except that's not what I expected. She's back, and tempting me like no one else has. And while I'm certain I'll only tarnish her shine, I want her. Only her. I'd heard the old notion that one night held the power to change everything. I never believed it. Until now. Then I downloaded a box set. I downloaded Love Those Curves by Sarah Hazel. This is still available to download for free. This is the perfect introduction to the sugary, sweet, and steamy world of Sarah Hazel. This box set contains three of her curvy romance novellas in a wide range of genres that she writes in. All books have that insta-love flavor you've come to expect from her. The books include a mafia romance, which is dirty curvy, a dark romance, which is her curves, his obsession, and Mountain Men Romance, which is a mountain man's curvy love. Then I downloaded A Love Divided by Bella McGinnis. This is a Scottish historical romance. This is still available to download for free. More interested in raiding into Scotland with the rest of her clan than womanly pursuits like embroidery or finding a husband, Alexandra Graham is a strong-minded English heiress who rides and fights as well as any man. But when a daring rescue goes wrong, she ends up in the dungeons of Scotland's most forbidding castle, prisoner of the notorious Earl of Bothwell, and at the mercy of the Queen's justice. As deputy warden responsible for keeping the law on his queen's borderlands, Michael Cransdowne is a Scottish laird with a reputation for fair-mindedness and the looks of a Viking warrior. But when he meets the beguiled Alexandra, both his life and his honor are at risk, not to mention his affections. With more than just the border separating them, Alex and Michael are on opposite sides of an ancient divide and destined for different paths. But a shared love for horses draws them together and kindles a passion that respects no boundaries, endangering more than just their hearts. I then downloaded Heavy, a Bad Boy Next Door Romance by Amelia Wilde. This is available to download for free still. I swore I'd never go back to Greenville. When I was a kid, my dad's anger turned me black and blue, but I turned it into a nice, stable salary. I don't care if being a heavy for the city's most dangerous drug dealer is illegal. It pays. But the old man has cancer, and whatever I am, I'm not a monster. I want to say goodbye, but I'm sure as hell I'm not going to linger. I'll get in, I'll get out, and get on with my life. Leave it to Zelda to ruin my plans. She's too good for me and I know it. Zelda is hopeful and kind and spends her days charming people at the local library. She's a saint. And the way she looks at me, her eyes full of raw desire, she should be mine. But if I fall for her, I put her in harm's way. I hurt the only person I really care about. The only problem? It's too late. I then downloaded Forever Theirs, an MMF romance, which is also book number two in the Twisted Heart series by Katie Robert. I'm not gonna read the summary for this one because it is book number two in a like series that comes like together. Like you have the book one would kind of like spoil book two a little bit. I believe the first book in this series is always free and you can go check it out. But this is a romance between a prince, I believe his bodyguard, and then a woman that they meet. Pretty steamy. I then downloaded The Princess and the Alpha, a shifter romance by K.M. Carnaby. This is available off Kindle Unlimited, or you can purchase it for $2.99. Princess Adeline is a werewolf princess who is next in line for the throne of her kingdom. At 19, she has yet to find her mate, which is why her parents have decided to throw a ball so she can meet potential suitors. One midnight, after surviving a horseback excursion that went awry, she meets an alpha who rules over a pack of various rogues just outside her kingdom. These rogues have long been banished and are ostracized by other werewolves in various packs, including her own. Their alpha just so happens to be the one person she is destined to be with, her mate. Then I downloaded another box set. I downloaded the Bride Hunt box set by Charlene Hart Nady. This is available off Kindle Limited, or you can purchase the box set for $4.99. It has the first three books in the series, but I just got this so I could get the third book for free. These are dragon shifter romances that I really like. Then I downloaded On a Tuesday by Whitney G. This is available off of Kindle Limited, or you can purchase it for $4.99. We met on a Tuesday, became best friends then lovers on a Tuesday, and everything fell apart on a Tuesday. Charlotte Taylor has three automatic strikes in my book. One, she hates me. She also claims that I'm a domineering jerk with a huge overbearing ego. Two, she takes our mandatory tutoring sessions way too seriously. And three, she's sexy as hell and a virgin. At least those were her strikes before our study sessions started lasting longer than they were supposed to, until one innocent kiss became 100 dirty ones until she became the first woman I ever fell hard for. Our future together after graduation was supposed to be set. Professional football for me, law school for her. But she left me at the end of the semester with no explanation, and then she completely disappeared from my life until tonight. We met on a Tuesday, became everything, then nothing on a Tuesday, and now it's 7 years later on a Tuesday. Then I have Blood and Bone by CC Wood. This is available to download for $3.99. Chloe MacArthur has finally found her mate, but he's the one wolf she can't have. To save her heart from further pain, she leaves the pack that she's come to consider her family. Unfortunately, unfinished business leads her back to her childhood home and straight into a deadly game with shifters that will do anything to prevent her from learning the truth. Ian Lachlan is in mourning. Nearly 2 years ago, he lost his mate, but thanks to Chloe, he's finally living again. When he wanted to give up and die, she saved him. Now Chloe is the one thing who needs help, and Lachlan plans to return the favor. Intent on protecting her from her enemies, he follows Chloe and soon discovers that he wants far more from her than friendship. He wants everything she has to give. But can either of them let go of the past long enough to reach for their future? And lastly, I downloaded Hold Me Tight, a high school friends to lovers steamy standalone romance by KJ Blake. This is available off of Kindle Unlimited, or you can purchase it for $2.99. Kylie. We met on the first day of school. He defended me when the other boys started laughing at me. He fought with them, saying that it's not appropriate to talk to a lady like that. He was a real gentleman, even at the age of 6. I fell in love with him right away, but I knew he'd never love me back. That's why I agreed to move abroad. Too bad it didn't help me to forget him. Tyler. I tried to kiss her, but she rejected me. I started dating other girls, but she never got jealous. I hated myself for not being able to stop loving her. Even after almost a year without her, I still miss her. My father always told me you can have whatever the F you want if you're powerful enough. It's time to see if that's true. Today, she's finally coming back home. I'll do anything to make her love me back. And there's no way I'll ever let her go again. So there you have it. Those are all of the books that I ended up downloading in the month of February. Please let me know down below if you have read any of these books or if you plan to. But anyways, thank y'all so much for watching. I will see y'all soon in my next one. Bye, y'all.